Hello and welcome. My name is Natalia Bendito and I'm a program manager for JavaScript and Node.js end-to-end developer experience in Azure. This brand new series is for developers wanting to build and deploy their applications to our Azure App Service. In our previous video, we created a new web app directly from our VS Code instance using the Azure App Service extension, and we deployed it to Azure without ever leaving our IDE. We also went to the portal and set up our CI/CD pipeline by linking our repo from the deployment center in the web app overview. We got our Express.js application built, deployed, and published within minutes. And now we will add a database and blob storage, also from VS Code, using the database and storage extensions. Before we create our database and blob storage, let's review our prerequisites. Please make sure you meet the following prerequisites. You need to have Node.js LTS installed with npm, Git and a GitHub account to complete our GitOps deployment, and VS Code and the following Azure extensions: Azure App Service, Azure Databases extension, and Azure Storage extension. I also recommend you start the series from the video number 1, following the URL on screen or in the description. Let's now create our database. We will provision a CosmosDB serverless instance by again going to the sidebar, clicking on Databases, selecting our subscription, and using the command palette to create a new database server. We will select an Azure database server, like in our case, Azure CosmosDB for MongoDB API. We will provide a CosmosDB account name, we will select serverless for the capacity model. We will need to select a resource group from our list of resource groups or create a new one. We will select a location for our resource and let the CosmosDB VS Code extension do its magic. When the system has finished creating the server, we will see it listed. Now we can create our database and a collection to store our listing. Let's again use the command palette for that. We will choose MongoDB, create database. We will choose again our subscription. We will select our server and enter the name of the database. Now we have a database, we will create a collection. We will enter the name of the collection, in our case, listings. And that's it. Now we have a database server, we have a database and a collection all ready to start loading documents. We can already start filling in our environment variables by retrieving the connection string, the database name, the connection name, and saving it to a .env file like the one I'm going to show you now. We can get the connection string by selecting our server, right-clicking on it, and selecting Copy Connection String. That will copy the connection string to the clipboard. Now we have a database, we will use the storage extension to create our blob storage and be able to store images. Remember, you need to have all extensions installed as per the prerequisites listed. Just like we did in order to create a database server and database and the app resource, we will select the desired subscription from the list under storage, create a storage account with the command palette. Enter a globally unique name again. And wait while it creates the resources. Once the storage account has been created and enabled, we can expand it to see it will have blob containers, file shares, queues, and tables. We will expand blob container, right click on it, and select create a new container or create blob container. In my case, I will call it rental. As with the database, we can copy and paste the connection string directly from the VS Code extension by right-clicking and expanding the menu. And be able to complete our environment variables configuration, again, our .env file. In this case, I am showing you the sample. To make sure our deployment is successful, we will need to add these variables to the configuration in the portal. So we will expand the App Service VS Code extension, find our application, and click Open in Portal. Once we're there, we will go to the Settings on the left side panel, click on Configuration, and start creating our environment variables. Just remember that they need to be called exactly as they are called in your .env file. So for example, if we copy our string MongoDB underscore URI underscore database underscore name, and our database was called nvcontoso app.db, we save it, and we should see it created. We will need to create all variables for the application to work. Once we're done, we just save it and continue. Once we're done adding them all, we're ready to run a new build and deploy workflow and start adding listings. But first, let's go to GitHub and see it running. We go to Overview, we copy the GitHub project to the clipboard, go to Actions, go to our Build and Deploy Node.js application workflow, and click on Run Workflow. This will start a new workflow run with a workflow underscore dispatch event trigger. And we can see the progress at all times. We can cancel the workflow if we need to. And we can see the time elapsed. It's finally built and the deploy is in queue. Now the deploy is in progress. And we know that it is deploying to production. Fantastic! Wasn't that easy? We created an application, a database, and blob storage, built and deployed and published it, and it's working within minutes, and all from our VS Code editor and our GitHub account. Let's go and add some listings. We will click on Add New Rental. We will give it a name. We will give it a description. We will choose a file. We will select the number of bedrooms, the number of bathrooms, a location, and link to more information. And that's it. It's created. Wonderful. Now let's hand over to Jason for more amazing features.